I'll be talking about this chemical kinetics. You know what chemical kinetics is? In chemical kinetics, you study about rates of chemical reactions. Yeah, in chemical kinetics, we study about the rates of chemical reactions and their mechanism. These two things only we'll be studying there in the chemical kinetics. Chemical kinetics, we'll be talking only about the rates of the reactions and their mechanism. What's the meaning of mechanism? Fine. That is what we'll discuss first here. In this chemical kinetics chapter, first we'll discuss about the mechanism of the reaction. So in this chemical kinetics, we'll be talking about the study of reactions and their mechanism. Kinesis word, from there only this kinetics is derived. Kinesis means movement. So in this reaction, movement will be there. Reactants will be getting changed into products. So since there is movement of, or you can say conversion of reactants into products, that's why this name of this chapter is chemical kinetics. See, in mechanism, what you will study? See, from your home, you'll be going to your school. So what will be the sequence of incidents? What will be the sequence of steps or incidents that comes under mechanism of reaction? Mechanism of reaction means the sequence wise study of different steps involved in any chemical reaction. That is called mechanism of reaction. Mechanism means what takes place first, what next. This sequence wise study of different steps involved in any chemical reaction is called mechanism of reaction. Fine. And what rate of reaction is? Rate of reaction means what amount of reactant will be changing into product. What amount of reactant is changing into product and time taken for that change. That is called rate of reaction. So what's the meaning of rate of reaction? Rate of reaction means what amount of reactant will be getting changed into product and the time taking for that change, that comes under rate of reaction. This is rate of reaction. See, before discussing further about chemical kinetics, we will discuss what was the need of this chapter, what was the need of this branch of chemistry, chemical kinetics. Because thermodynamics tells you only about the feasibility of a reaction. Whether that reaction will be possible or not, thermodynamics will tell you this only. Thermodynamics will tell you only about the feasibility of a reaction and do not provide any information about the wide variation in speeds of. Thermodynamics will never tell you about the speed of the chemical reaction. From chemical kinetics only, we will come to know about the speed of the reaction, about the rate of the reaction. Thermodynamically, you can convert diamond to graphite. But this reaction is very slow because its activation energy is very high. So kinetically, conversion of diamond into graphite will not be possible because this reaction will be very, very slow. Now they'll be asking you why this conversion, first question, why conversion of diamond to graphite is not possible? Because thermodynamically it is not possible. So they will ask you why thermodynamically it is not possible. Thermodynamically it is possible, but kinetically it is not possible. Why kinetically this conversion of diamond to graphite is not possible? Because this reaction is very, very slow. Now they'll be asking you why this reaction is very, very slow kinetically. So you will say that since their activation energy is very high. What's the meaning of activation energy? Activation energy is that energy which is minimal amount of energy which is required to initiate any chemical reaction. If that activation energy will be very, very high, then that reaction will not be possible. So only those reactions are possible which have relatively lower activation energy value. If activation energy value will be very, very high, then that reaction will never be possible. So what I was telling you, conversion of diamond to graphite, thermodynamically, it is possible. It is highly feasible, but kinetically, it won't be possible. Speed wise, it won't be possible. Why? Because its speed will be very, very, very slow. Now they'll be asking you why its speed is very, very slow. They will be first asking you why or how it is not feasible. So you'll say kinetically it won't be feasible. So they'll be asking you why kinetically it is not feasible. So you'll tell that because its rate is very, very slow. Now they'll be asking you why the rate of this conversion of diamond to graphite is very slow. So you'll say that very high activation energy. Now nobody can ever ask you why their activation energy is very high. Fine, nobody further asks you any question. So in this way, they may be asking you questions. They are there in class 12th board exams or in entrance level exams. So now this point is over. At the macroscopic level, we are interested in amounts reacted or formed and the rates of their consumption or formation. And at the molecular level, the reaction mechanism involving orientation and energy of molecules undergoing collisions are discussed. So in this chapter, we will not only be discussing about the various examples. In those various examples, we'll be talking about the mechanism of reaction. In this chapter, we'll be talking about the rates of the reaction. And rate of reactions not only depends upon energy. If reactants are having sufficient energy, then they will collide and will get converted into products. If reactants have sufficient energy, then only reactants will collide effectively and will get converted into products. First thing, that reactants must have sufficient energy, then only they will get converted into product. So not only sufficient energy, but see, if one reactant is like this and second reactant is like this, then they will never come in contact with each other and will never get converted into product. So not only sufficient energy, but proper orientation. Orientation must be like this. If it is like this, then reactants will never come in contact with each other and will never get converted into product. So there must be sufficient energy of reactant molecules, first thing, and orientation also must be proper, then only reactants will get converted into products. If orientation won't be proper, if energy won't be sufficient, then reactants will never get converted into products. So this is a very, very important thing. So not only energy of molecules, their proper orientation is also very, very important. Then only reactants will get converted into products. Otherwise, reactants will never get converted into products. Fine. So now once again, I'll repeat the same what up till now we have done in this chapter. If you know what we'll be studying there in that chapter, then it will be very easy for you to handle that chapter. In this chapter, you'll be talking about the rate of reaction and mechanism of reaction. What was the need of this chapter? Because thermodynamically, many things can be possible, but kinetically, it won't be possible. Thermodynamics will tell you whether this reaction will be feasible or not, but it will never let you know that what will be the rate of the reaction. So if you want to know the rate of any chemical reaction, then thermodynamics won't be sufficient for explaining that. So then you need another branch of chemistry which can tell you about the speed of the reaction. and that branch of chemistry is called chemical kinetics. So in chemical kinetics, you will not only be studying rates of the reaction, but you will be talking about the mechanism of those reactions, and not only rate of reaction and mechanism of reaction, you will be studying there in this chapter about the energy of the reactants and proper orientation of the reactant molecules. Reactant molecules must have some sufficient minimum energy, and their orientation must also be proper. Then only reactants will get converted into products. Otherwise, reactants will never get converted into products. Are you getting my point? Asta, is it okay? Likhita, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now we will go to the next part in this chapter. In this chapter, as I told you, we will be talking about the mechanism of the reaction and the rate of the reaction. So mechanism of reaction, now what left is from mechanism of reaction? Left is just a few examples. There we will be talking which step is the first step, which is the second step, which is the third step, and out of these three, two or four or five steps, which will be the slowest step, that we will be talking. So that is that we will do in coming topics. We'll discuss so many reactions, and not only reaction, but we'll be discussing about their mechanism also. How many steps are involved there in that specific reaction, and which one is the slowest one. So now here we'll be talking about the rates of the reaction. You know, you can classify reactions into many classes: very fast reactions, moderate reactions, and very slow reactions. You know, very fast reactions, photochemical reactions, this vision reaction, you are observing something, you are looking, you are just viewing something, that is vision reaction, and that is retinal isomerization also. So photochemical reactions, those reaction which takes place in presence of light. Photochemical reactions means those chemical reactions which takes place, in presence of light are called photochemical reaction. For example, vision reaction is also known as retinal isomerization, because when you see something, there will be isomerization reaction there in your retina, and if that isomerization will be there, then only we can see anything. And that retinal isomerization can only be possible in presence of light. If light is present, then only that retinal isomerization will take place, and then only we can see any object. So retinal isomerization, that's an example of photochemical reaction. That's an example of chemical reactions which are taking place in presence of light, and it is one of the fastest chemical reactions. It takes around 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 16 seconds to get completed. In how much time these photochemical reactions get completed? These photochemical reaction takes around 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 16 seconds for their completion. So fastest chemical reactions, fine, fastest chemical reactions. This is one example. Then second example is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis also takes place in presence of sunlight. So it is also an example of photochemical reaction. It is also an example of very, very fast chemical reactions, one of the fastest chemical reactions. So fastest chemical reaction takes around 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 16 seconds. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So just remember these points. See, here vision and photosynthesis is written. You know about both of these reactions. Without light, won't be possible. Now, if some other chemical reaction there, see H2 plus Cl2. In that reaction, they will be writing like this H nu. H nu means E is equal to H nu. Na? That is Planck's equation. Na? That is sunlight. H nu means E. E means energy. Energy means solar energy. So H nu. This is also photochemical reaction. So for photochemical reactions, they will be writing like this. They will be writing like this. So you will come to know that's a photochemical reaction. But in exam, they may not be writing this all. So now you should know that out of all these reactions, how many are possible in presence of light only? How many of them are possible in presence of light only? Those reactions will be photochemical reactions. Fine. So photochemical reactions are fastest chemical reactions. And what reactions you will be studying there in your syllabus, whatever reactions are there in your syllabus, whatever you will be studying, all those reactions are moderate rate reactions. Their speed is neither too high nor too slow. So are moderate reactions. What about slow reactions? Slow reaction takes around months or days to get completed. You know, corrosion, rusting. Corrosion requires months na to get completed. So it is a very, very slow reaction. Now see, ionic reactions are also fast reactions. Ionic reactions or inorganic reactions are also fast reactions. They take around 10 to the power minus 6 seconds for their completion. Why these reactions are fast? Because ionic bond is weak bond. So since it is weaker bond, and you can say precipitation of AgCl also is a fast reaction. It takes place instantaneously, fine, because ionic reactions. Then inversion of cane sugar and hydrolysis of a starch are moderate rate reactions. Their speed will be around 10 to the power minus 2 seconds. Conversion of H2O2 into H2O and O2 is also moderate reaction, fine. And usually organic reactions, covalent reactions, molecular reactions, or reversible reactions are very slow because covalent bond is so strong, so difficult to break. Rusting of iron in the presence of air and moisture is also an example of very slow reaction. Usually irreversible reactions are fast reactions, and reversible reactions or equilibrium reactions are slow reactions. Fine. So now we'll see that speed of a reaction or the rate of reaction can be expressed in terms of how much amount of reactant is getting converted into product. Means how much amount of reactant getting disappeared. That is called rate of decrease in concentration of any of the reactant. Or you can say rate of increase in concentration of any of the product. How much amount of product will be found? How much amount of product will be appearing? That is also rate of reaction. Rate of reaction, you can say that how much amount of reactant is getting disappeared, or you can say how much amount of product are getting appeared there in chemical reaction. That is also rate of reaction. C, this is time, this is concentration. So with time, concentration of product always increases, and with time, concentration of reactant always decreases. Concentration of product with time always increases, and concentration of reactant with time always decreases. Reactant always decreases. Initially, reactant will be maximum, and as reaction proceeds, amount of reactant getting decreased. And with time, initially there won't be any product, and with time, the amount of product or concentration of product increases with time and amount of reactant or concentration of reactant with time decreases. See here, if we'll draw the tangent, if we'll draw the tangent for product, then tangent rate will always be, tangent rate will always be having a positive slope, increasing slope. And if you are talking about the tangent rate of reactant, then with time it decreases. Tangent rate, since it decreases, so you'll be writing minus slope. Minus means decreases, going down, and plus means increasing, means going up. So reactant tangent increases and product tangent decreases with time. So you'll be writing here slope, and there you'll be writing minus slope. That is what I have written here, there in this graph. Now see, suppose, since you are talking about the rate of the reaction, two types of rates can be there. See, suppose we are studying, we have joined these classes around 20 days before. So from last 20 days around, we are having this classes, these classes. So in 20 days, how many pages we have finished? Suppose we have finished 90 pages. In 20 days, you have finished around 90 pages. So in one day, how many pages are done? This will be 90 upon 20. This will be average rate of reaction. Average rate of reaction. Average rate of reaction means in a given interval of time, how much reactant is converted into product. That is average rate of reaction. Now see, exact rate of reaction. On 13th of June, what have you done? Zero page. On 14th of June, you have done one page. On 15th, you have done 16 pages. Like this, we have done this all. So like this, we'll be doing this all. So in this way we can do this all. So two modes are there. Fine. Two modes are there. One is average rate of reaction and second is exact rate of reaction. One is average rate of reaction and second is exact rate of reaction. Is it clear? Average rate means in a big interval of time, you have studied so many pages. So in one day, how many pages are covered? And in exact rate, it will be exactly on any specific day, at a specific point of time, how much work is done, how much reactant is converted into product in a specific point of time, that is called exact rate of reaction. What's the meaning of exact rate of reaction? Exact rate of reaction and average rate of reaction. Average rate of reaction means in a given interval of time, how much reactant is converted into product, that is average rate of reaction. And at any specific point of time, what amount of reactant is converted into product? At any specific point of time, what amount of reactant is converted into product, that is called exact rate of reaction. So now here in this part of chemistry, in this part of chemical kinetics, we'll be talking about the types of rates of reactions. Rates of reactions can be of two types. One is average rate of reaction and second is exact rate of reaction. Is this clear, Likhita?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any doubt?
No, sir.
Fine. So best thing, in last 20 days, how many pages you have done? So in one day, how many pages will be finished? This is average rate. And specifically date wise, if you'll be asking that on 13th of July, what is done? Nothing is done. On 15th of July, three pages are done. On 17th of July, 1.5 pages done. This will be exact rate of reaction. That is at a rate of reaction at any specific point of time. That is exact rate of reaction or instantaneous rate of reaction. That is exact rate of reaction. That is exact rate of reaction or instantaneous rate of reaction. That is average rate of reaction or instantaneous rate of reaction. And if any given interval of time, then that rate will be known as average rate of reaction. So average rate of reaction, average rate of reaction, then you will be writing minus R upon T or P upon T. But if it is exact rate of reaction, if it is exact rate of reaction, then you'll be here, you'll be writing minus R upon T or P upon T. Minus Y you have written because reactants always with time decreases now. So that's why decreases means minus. And product always increases with time. Now concentration of product always increases with time. So that's why you have written here plus. Or you can write it like this too. Del X upon del T. Fine, del X upon del T. This will be average rate of reaction. And about exact rate or instantaneous rate of reaction, then you'll be writing minus D active mass of R upon dT. Or D active mass of P upon dT. See, this P is written positive because product always increases with time. And what about reactant? Reactant always decreases with time. Now see here what the difference is. Here time you have taken is T and here time is dT. What's the difference between these two? This dT is a very, very small interval of time. It is the smallest interval of time. dT is the smallest interval of time. If we'll decrease time anymore, if we'll decrease time further, if dT is reduced further, then this change in concentration of reactant or product will become zero. There will not be any change in concentration of reactants and or products. So this dT is such a small interval of time. This dT is such a small interval of time. If we'll further reduce time, then this dT, then there will not be any change in concentration of reactants and products. So it will be such a small interval of time. So that's the difference between this dT and this T. This T is a larger interval of time and this dT is the smallest interval of time. If we'll further reduce the time, then the change in concentration of reactants or products will get zero, will become zero. There will not be any change in concentration of reactants and products, means no reaction will be taking place. So here, once again, minus means always reactants, means with time always reduces. Concentration of reactant with time always decreases, and P is plus means with time concentration of product always increases. Fine. So now this is about the average rate and exact rate of reaction. So exact rate or instantaneous rate and average rate, these two rates you'll be here discussing. So now we'll go to the C. This is one exact rate of reaction. This is one exact rate of reaction. This is another exact rate of reaction. This is third exact rate of reaction. These are three exact rates of reaction at three different points of time. Three different points of time. This is C1, T1, that is first rate of reaction, and time 2, C2, T2, this is second rate of reaction, and time T, third time T3, the rate of reaction is C3, T3. So these C1, T1, C2, T2, and C3, T3 are different exact rates of reaction. These three rates of reactions will combine together. These three rates of reactions will combine together to form. These three rates of reaction will combine together to form. These three rates of reaction will combine together to form. These three rates of reaction will combine together to form average rate of reaction. These three rates of reaction will combine together to form average rate of reaction. Fine. So many exact rates of reaction or instantaneous rates of reaction will combine together to form an average rate of reaction. C1, T1, C2, T2, and C3, T3 are three exact rates, and all three combined together are average rates. So graphically, you can show these exact rates and how exact rates are different from average rates. Fine, R is always concentration of reactant, and P is always concentration of product. So this is concentration, this is concentration, and this is time. So this is concentration versus time graph, concentration of reactant and product versus time graph. And if slope is going down, what does it mean? It is minus slope, and will always be concentration of reactants. Will always be concentration of reactants. If they'll be asking you what C1, C2, and C3 are, so they may ask you, if graph is going like this, so this must be concentration of reactant. And if graph goes like this, then that must be the concentration of product. This is slope, and this is minus slope. So minus slope is always for reactants, and plus slope is always for products. So with time, concentration of reactant always decreases, and with time, concentration of product always increases. Fine. So now there is one example. That N2 plus thrice H2 gives twice NH3. N2 plus thrice H2 gives twice NH3. That is Haber's process. That is industrial method of preparation of ammonia. Ammonia that is also known as azane. Ammonia is also known as azane. So N2 plus thrice H2 gives twice H3. See, if you see dH upon dt is equal to minus d active mass of N2 upon dt. See here, how many moles of N2 are there? One mole. And since it is reactant, that's why you have written minus. So minus d active mass of N2 upon dt is equal to, now see how many moles of hydrogen are there? Three. So you'll equate them now. So to equate them, you have to multiply it by 1/3. And why minus? Because it is reactant now. So minus 1/3 d active mass of H2 upon dt is equal to. Now see, it is products now. And how many moles are there? Since products, so plus. And how many moles are there? Two. So if you want to equate with one, so what we need to do, you have to multiply it by half. Active mass of D into NH3, active mass of NH3 upon DT. So in this way, you will express exact rate of reaction or instantaneous rate of reaction. dH upon dt is equal to minus D. Active mass of N2 upon dt is equal to minus 1/3 d active mass of H2 upon dt is equal to half d active mass of NH3 upon dt. So in this way, we will be expressing this industrial method of preparation of ammonia in terms of chemical kinetics, in terms of exact rate of reaction, in terms of instantaneous rate of reaction. Fine. Or how they can ask you, they will be asking you, what will be the active mass of NH3 upon DT? And here they will be writing you minus D active mass of N2 upon DT. And here you need to fill up. What you will be writing here. They will be asking you a question like this. So NH3 upon DT is half. So this half 2 will be shifted here. So you have to write minus 2 minus D active mass of N2 upon DT. This 2 will be shifted to this side now. So then what you will get? You will get 2 minus D upon D into N2 upon DT. If they will be asking you what here in case of D active mass of H2 upon DT, this is minus this half will be shifted here. So what you will get? You will get 2/3. So in this way, they will be asking you questions. So what is the relationship between D active mass of NH3 upon DT with minus D active mass of N2 upon DT, or with minus D active mass of H2 upon DT? So with N2, it is 2. And with H2, it is minus 2/3. Are you getting this point? They may be asking you questions like this. Likhita, is it okay? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So they may be asking you this all questions. See, how can I bother you? How can I make it difficult? How can your teacher make it difficult? So simply here they have written like this. But if they won't be writing like this, they will be asking you Haber's process. If you are knowing Haber's process, then it is okay for you. If you don't know, then we will get 0. They may be asking you that industrial method of preparation of nitric acid or sulfuric acid or ammonia or this or that. So we must know this, all these names of different reactions. Then only we can handle. Otherwise, it can be a problem for us. So in this way, they can ask you in entrance if you'll do all these question papers now, then you will come to know about all these questions, how they'll be asking you. So all these questions are there in our previous year's question papers. They are in ITJEE or NEET. Now see, if this reaction N2 plus rise H2 reversible twice NH3, what they have said here? 2.8 gram of nitrogen, 2.8 gram nitrogen. Then how much NH3 will be formed? How many grams of NH3 will be formed? See here, how many grams of nitrogen are there? 28 gram. And here, how many grams of NH3 are there? 3 plus 14, 17, 17, 2 is 34. 28 gram nitrogen gives 34 gram NH3. So 2.8 gram nitrogen will give 2.8 gram nitrogen will give 3.4 gram of NH3. This is easy one, but how they can ask you this question? They are in the mole concept. That I'll explain you here. Here I'll get the chance to explain you limiting reagent. Fine. So is this all okay? Should I go to the next one?